Louisiana native James Damian Stelly is making his third appearance with the Art of War and is hoping to extend his perfect record in the promotion. Stelly will be facing one of his toughest opponents tonight when he goes head-to-head with Luis Baña Arturo Kane.
The guy, he's tough. You know, he's undefeated. I think I'm the better fighter. Try to go out there, feel him out a little bit, make sure he doesn't catch me something crazy. It's going to be a battle, man. I'm going to win.
Kane is an explosive Muay Thai fighter who also possesses a very strong jiu-jitsu background. He has a remarkable training history that includes 6 years with Hyun Gracie of the legendary Gracie family. Whether it's his knockout power or fluid ground game, Kane is considered by many to be one of the sport's rising stars.
Eu acho que isso eu vou ganhar.
I am going to be victorious because I've trained so much. I couldn't train anymore. I couldn't have done any more to prepare for this fight. I am just ready to win. It's going to be my victory.
Coming up next, James Damian Stelly versus Luis Arturo Kane.
In his way to the ring now, the Blue Fighter.
Making his way to the Art of War cage from Sao Paulo, Rio de Janeiro. Somewhere along the beautiful beaches of Brazil, it's Luis Baña Arturo Kane. He's a Muay Thai fighter, very strong jiu-jitsu background, and really when it comes to Brazilians, and I asked the head of Brazilian top teams in Mario Sperry, he told me the best fundamentals for a mixed martial arts athlete would be Muay Thai and jiu-jitsu. Of course, you being a wrestler, you might have something else to say about that, but a mixture of that, those two fundamentals, and you're pretty well on your way to having some kind of an idea of what a mixed martial artist is.
Yeah, I mean, that's true, because the one thing that wrestling really does, wrestling, you're not going to really finish a fight with wrestling. You're not gonna. All that wrestling really does is change that position. So, see, Mario Spirit, I think it's pretty true in that statement.
Of course, his best weapon is Muay Thai, which leads to the knockout power. Also very fluid on the ground. He has trained 6 years with the loose cannon of the Gracie family, Hyun Gracie. So obviously has a little bit of that Gracie edge to him as well. Luis Baña Arturo Kane making his Art of War debut. Undefeated fighter as well. 7 fights, 6 victories, 1 no contest.
A very interesting matchup. It's because he relies more on his Muay Thai skill than his jiu-jitsu skill. His jiu-jitsu skill is more of a second thought for him. So being in a position that can easily finish, you can easily get out of, and he tends to think about it later, he's always looking for the striking first. I want to see how much he's improved as of late.
Now, making his way to the ring, the Red Fighter.
You gotta love somebody who walks to the cage with a little CCR in the background, my friend, from Louisiana, James Damian Stelly. Member of Modern Army Combatives, he burst onto the Art of War scene with an impressive victory over Mike Shepard via Kimura in the very first Art of War show back in March of this year. He continued his winning streak in Art of War number 2 in Austin, Texas, with an impressive win over Swedish veteran Klas Åkesson via second round rear naked choke. So, Trigg, you look at his best weapon, it is the submission game. He's looking to make it 3 in a row here tonight.
He's a little bit of a raw fighter. Got it, that's not as versed in any one thing, but definitely likes to do as much as he possibly can because he's one of those guys that tries everything. He's not scared to try it. He's really gonna do anything that he possibly can to kind of maintain his fight on his feet. He prefers to be in a stand, than just be on the ground. Tends to use a little bit too much energy when he's defending things.
All right, let's take a look at the tail of the tape for this light heavyweight matchup between Baña Kane and James Damian Stelly. Stelly, 1 year younger than Kane. Kane with 2 inches in height, both weighing in at 205 pounds. And what Art of War refers to as the effective reach. And Trigg, the effective reach means what?
It's from the armpit to the fist length. So you make a fist, you put your arms straight out in front of your body, range it from your armpit to your fifth, as opposed to what you see in boxing, which is always from fingertip across your back to other fingertip.
So Connie has a 1-inch advantage in effective reach. We are all set for this light heavyweight contest.
Ladies and gentlemen, this bout is scheduled for 3 5-minute rounds. Introducing first, fighting out of the blue corner, wearing black trunks, this man holds a professional record of 6 wins, 0 losses. He's 6'2" tall. He weighs 204 and a half pounds. From Sao Paulo, Brazil, Banya, Luis Arturo Gagne. Fighting next, out of the red corner, this man holds a record of 7 wins, 1 loss. He weighed in at 204 and one half pounds. From Columbus, Georgia, the Omen, Damian Stelling. Your referee for this fight is Kerry Hatley.
Pre-fight instructions in the dressing rooms. Any questions here? Any questions here? Take stuff at all times. Here we go, man.
Whatever.
Luis Banya Artur Cane against James Damian Stelly in this light heavyweight contest here at Art of War 3, set for 3 5-minute rounds. The two-touch gloves, it'll be Connie in the black and white trunks, James Damian Stelly in the predominantly white trunks. And immediately Connie openings up on Stelly, takes him to the cage, has the body lock, and this could lead to a takedown again with the over-under hooks.
Nice step around, see how Connie stepping around behind his back leg, swinging around trying to get to his backside. This will give him a better spot. If he just dips his legs right now, Stelly will fall to the ground.
And it should clarify, it's not a full body lock, but yes, a very nice throw there by James Damian Stelly. And now Kane working the rubber guard from the bottom. Plants an elbow on the head of Stelly, looking to maneuver here, and it's all about the hip movement. And Stelly looking to pass the guard, stacking up Kane. Now Kane goes for the leg, looking for the heel, and now it's Stelly attacking the leg of Connie. Back and forth,
wow,
we go.
Good rolling, good motion. Both guys just had good two submission attempts back to back right there. They're obviously not sitting on their laurels trying to knock these guys out.
Good sprawl by Connie as they now will bring it back up to their feet. Connie looking to overpower Stelly up along the cage, delivers a knee strike to the abdomen. Stelly looking to go the knee route as well. A weak shot there as Connie now has him again up along the cage. What does Stelly have to do here, Trigg, to try to turn the tables?
He's got to turn his hips off. He's content. His feet are square. He's got one foot in front of the other. And then turn his hips off the cage. Not just drive into a guy, but spin him off the cage, try to change positions.
And that's what Stelly now slowly is doing, as they are now in the center of the cage. They separate. Nice left hand there by Cunning. Nice high kick blocked by Connie. Left high kick as well. Stelly showing his ambidexterity.
He eats a left hand right after that because he left his hands on after he kicked. There's great kicks, but keep your hands up at the end of it.
Knee strike there. Oh, and a second knee. And obviously, Stelly's got a tough beard, but he may indeed be on roller skates right now. If he takes another knee strike, down he goes, and this one could be over quick.
He's still fighting. Wow, he's got a tough chin. He took 3 knees straight.
And another one. He continues to eat those punches. Referee Kerry Hatley right on the spot overseeing it. Boy, what a tough, tough fighter James Damian Stelly is, eating all kinds of strikes, absorbing all kinds of punishment at the hands of Luis Banya Cane here in round number one.
And one of the things that will happen is if Cane smokes blunt, he keeps expending this much energy, he'll actually tire himself out as Stelly recovers.
And he is not intelligently defending those strikes, just eating them shot after shot. And now Cane showcasing his ground game, passes the guard. Stelly goes for the leg, looking for the ankle pick. Slips right out of it, and Connie again goes on the attack.
Oh,
and another knee.
Knee.
And this one should be stopped, and it is.
Wow, look at
this. Mercifully, the fight is over. And Cane, which in Italian means dog. I know he's Portuguese, but boy, showcasing some of that high-end Gracie bulldog mentality. Very tenacious, aggressive attack, systematically dismantling a game, but overmatched. James Stelly.
Stelly came out to show how tough his chin is, showed that he's got great wrestling ability, but definitely trying to shoot the, you know, do the takedown with the shots. He just wasn't competing and wasn't able to get him down to the ground. And, you know, really, Cane is just so tough. And he took a pretty couple of good head kicks. We didn't see him coming, took him pretty significantly, and just ran right through him and just was able to wear him down.